many women squeezed into an area with poor conditions to thrive, chances of making it beyond the remote villages by the impenetrable forest are slim. When Ivas Kemigisha tied the knot with Robert Kanama 25 years ago, she didn't know the responsibility of caring for their 9 children would fall on her shoulders. HIV and poverty have always overshadowed livelihood in Bwindi, but since they started weaving baskets in 2012, their fortunes transformed.
She still stays with the husband, but the husband has no support to the family at all. He actually resorted to alcoholism. She makes sure she's able to support the family in all ways.
As the name suggests, ride for a woman initially trained bicycle mechanics who'd maintain them for hire to tourists, but with the hilly terrain not much was earned. That is when the founder, Evelyn Rubarema, thought of a more industrious activity, weaving baskets. Trained in tourism and hospitality, her aim is to empower the 300 women enrolled to send their children to school.
If it wasn't for education, I wouldn't have gone back in my own community to actually help the women or to help my own community. So I've thought about if we could do this in our community and have more people educated, then that would actually help the community members. That is the only way we can actually fight the poverty, the domestic abuse.
There are baskets of all colors and sizes, and a woman earns from 6,000 shillings per day. The baskets are sold to tourists who come to visit. Those who are good at quilting teach and mentor others.
We realized that giving these women the money every day was not sustainable. Not every time we make sales, so we have the money every day. And taking money every day is also not something good because it may not do something big. So after 2 weeks, we thought about it being a reasonable sum of money to help them do something in their families. So with this money, they are actually also advised to do savings. Each woman here has an account where they can always take part of the money and save the rest so it can help them in any other way, save as in emergencies.
With a husband who lives in a bar, weaving baskets has empowered Ruth Thuria Mureba to be the breadwinner of her family. The 47-year-old is married with 3 children, and in this area she normally would be a housewife performing less tedious chores, but the lack of food, medical care and tuition fees has pushed her to be the breadwinner of her family. The skill of weaving baskets transformed her fortunes.
She actually finished primary 7, so she was not able to go on with education because of lack of school fees, and that made her find herself into marriage at an early age. So she's actually working hard. She tries to work hard so that her children can get to a certain level when it comes to education. She really wants them to be somewhere to have the quality education. She's trying to make sure she gets all it is needed by working with Ride for a Woman. She tries to save to make sure that all the 3 children get all the school requirements for school. And she also makes use of the small piece of land she has to grow as much as she can.
These women are riding on the tourism sector, which contributes 7.7% to Uganda's gross domestic product. On average, a woman takes home $2 for quilting per day. According to the World Bank, anyone living on less than $2.15 a day is considered to be living in extreme poverty. The hope here is that families can jump out of this bracket. That is it, the lives of 60 women being transformed with a simple yet powerful craft, weaving baskets in Bungoma, Western Uganda. I'm Razia Athman on the Mobile Storyline.